Back in 2021, a Qantas Boeing 7879 Dreamliner flew transpacific from Melbourne to Los Angeles with tape covering four fan cowl static ports. This was despite a Qantas engineer placing quote-unquote remove before flight barricade streamer tape on the covered static ports the day before the flight. While the 14-plus hour flight was uneventful, the incident triggered an investigation by the Australian Transport Safety Bureau, or ATSB. The ATSB released its findings concerning the September 22, 2021 incident. Let's take a look at this full incident in today's video. The Aviation Safety Agency found the aircraft departed with reduced redundancy to the engine electronic control system because the coverings were left in place. The ATSB also found that Qantas's own procedures did not identify all of the aircraft's static ports, and the procedure for restoring the plane back to service did not reference Boeing procedures. This allowed different interpretations of which ports would be covered. The incident involved Victor Hotel Zulu November Juliet, which was due to fly a freight flight from Melbourne, or MEL, to Los Angeles LAX on September 22nd. The night before, an engineer prepared the aircraft for the flight. This preparation included removing covers from the pitot probes and static ports. The following morning before departure, one of the flight crew conducted a pre-flight exterior inspection with no anomalies detected. The aircraft was also subject to a pre-departure exterior inspection by ground service dispatch personnel. Around 0900, the Dreamliner took off and set course for LAX. Flying time across the Pacific was 14 and a half hours. The flight was described as uneventful. Indeed, it was only during the post-flight inspection that the covered static ports were discovered. Static ports provide important air pressure data to aircraft systems, but the fuselage static ports and vertical fin static ports play the primary role. The fan cowl static port air pressure data is only used when an aircraft's engine electronic control determines that the data coming from the other static ports is unreliable. Let's take a look at the series of events that transpired before the flight and how this led to the mistake. Before flying out of Melbourne, the Boeing 7879 had sat idle for 39 hours. When an aircraft sits on the ground between 24 and 72 hours, Qantas requires it to be subject to normal parking procedures. These parking procedures include fitting pitot covers and covering the static ports in accordance with Boeing recommendations. The Boeing 7879 has 6 fuselage, 4 engine fan cowl, and 4 vertical fin static ports. On the evening of September 21st, a licensed aircraft maintenance engineer, or LAME, was asked to return the Dreamliner to flight status. This included uncovering the pitot and fuselage static ports and completing the other maintenance tasks. The LAME was unaware that the fan cowl ports had been covered earlier, but also didn't check to see if they were covered or uncovered during their job to prepare the 787 for flight. Another LAME was tasked to complete the return to service procedure the next morning, but the LAME did not inspect the aircraft, nor were they required to as part of this procedure. The certificate of release to service was signed off ahead of the flight crew arriving. Taking the plane to Los Angeles was a captain, 2 first officers, and 2 second officers. The captain tasked one of the second officers to conduct the pre-flight exterior inspection. The second officer commenced the exterior inspection at the aircraft's nose in line with standard procedures. The pilot found a pitot cover on the apron but could not establish whether that cover came from Victor Hotel Zulu November Juliet or another plane. The pilot gave the cover to an engineer who was also out on the apron. Back in the cockpit, the second officer mentioned the cover found on the ground but reported no other problems, and the inspection completed. Just before pushback, a contracted Donata dispatcher conducted their walk-around inspection and also did not notice the 4 covered static ports. The dispatcher gave the all clear, and the jet departed within minutes. Melbourne Airport CCTV footage revealed the fan cowl static port covers could be seen in certain views. Additionally, one of the LAMEs and an aircraft maintenance engineer, or AIM, walked past the engines several times while completing other maintenance tasks. However, there was no indication that either mechanic specifically looked at the engine fan cowl. CCTV footage also showed the second officer and the dispatcher did not conduct their exterior inspections in line with the documented procedures and exterior inspection route. The tape on the engine fan cowls was not removed by that engineer as per the manufacturer's procedures, and this wasn't identified by flight crew or dispatch during pre-departure checks, said ATSB Director Transport Safety Stuart McLeod earlier this month when reporting on the investigation's findings. While the flight was uneventful, the covered ports meant redundancy for the engine electronic control system was reduced. Worryingly, a similar incident occurred in Australia 4 years ago. In July 2018, a Malaysia Airlines A330-300 left Brisbane BNE with its three pitot probes covered and almost immediately began getting unreliable airspeed indications. The Airbus was able to turn around and land safely with assistance from Brisbane ATC. Unrelated to aircraft coverings, but definitely connected in terms of pre-flight aircraft preparation, a June 2021 incident resulted in a Qantas 787 being unable to retract its main landing gear on a flight from Sydney to Perth. The subsequent ATSB investigation found the failure to remove two of the five downlock pins before departure prevented the main landing gear from retracting after takeoff. Furthermore, the pins were also not identified during subsequent pre-flight inspections. The results of the investigation of this incident found that it was due to a combination of miscommunication, inexperience, and misunderstandings. One issue included incomplete checks of the pins and their storage in the 787's electrical equipment center, using a ladder that was too short to visually check the presence of all five pins. Instead of confirming visually, crews simply reached up into the electrical equipment center and felt around to ensure all pins were present, clearly counting and feeling around incorrectly. Going back to the September 2021 incident, the ATSB made several findings. The agency noted the meter-long tail of the remove-before-flight tape covering the static ports was stuck down to prevent it from being torn from the fuselage in strong winds, as per Boeing's recommended procedure. This likely reduced the visibility of it covering the fan cowl static port covers, said McLeod. The ATSB notes Qantas's maintenance procedures required the static ports to be covered, but did not specify the locations, allowing potentially different interpretations of the procedure between lames or engineers. In addition, the emphasis of the warnings was more in line with the fuselage static ports rather than possible issues associated with the fan cowl or vertical fin covers not being removed. When performing safety-critical tasks like aircraft maintenance, it's very important that procedures are clear and unambiguous to avoid misinterpretation and error such as occurred in this incident. Qantas has since made some changes to how their engineers and flight crews deal with aircraft inspections, including issuing an internal memo issued to flight operations detailing the fan cowl static ports and that they may be covered during parking. In addition, the memo noted that engineering may not necessarily conduct an exterior inspection before dispatch and highlighted the importance of flight crew vigilance to ensure they are an effective last line of defense in assessing the aircraft's readiness for flight. At the start of this year, Australian media outlet 7 News reported that Qantas had lost its top rank as one of the world's safest airlines. Qantas held the title of World's Safest Airline from 2014 to 2017, as well as 2019 to 2021. The most recent ranking for Qantas had the airline come in 7th place, reportedly due to a slight increase in incidents coupled with the fleet age. The media outlet noted that in October 2021, a Qantas jet travelling from Perth to Adelaide in Western Australia was diverted due to a fuel imbalance, an occurrence classified as a serious incident. It's uncertain if the other incidents in 2021 factored into the airline's most recent ranking on airlineratings.com. However, due to the presence of human error in many of these situations, it wouldn't be surprising if they did. Qantas currently operates a fleet of 11 Boeing 787-9 Dreamliner aircraft. These have an average age of just over 3.5 years, and although the airline is expecting an additional 3 more 787s, the arrival of these additional aircraft won't exactly lower this subfleet's average age. That's because the 3 undelivered 787s have already been built but are undeliverable due to Boeing's production and delivery issues, issues that are being worked through with the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA. What do you think of this incident? Does this affect your opinion of Qantas and their safety record? Share your opinion with us by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.